All games this week are competitive as Separation Saturday has begun, and it starts off with the Acworth Warriors and Douglasville Tiger Cubs at the 6-0 division. Douglasville kicks off to start the game, and they kick it to right to number 44, who is going to return the ball all the way down inside the 10-yard line. It is a great way for Acworth Warriors as they get started trying to get into the end zone against this Douglasville team. On the following play, they give it to number 21 with the end around, and he gets into the end zone as he gives Acworth the lead 6-0. Douglasville is now trying to establish itself on offense as they give it to the running back number 10, but number 15 from Acworth makes a big hit. But later on in the series, Douglasville says they're going to keep fighting as they give it back to number 10. He breaks about three tackles, heads down the sideline for a 60-yard touchdown run as Douglasville is trying to come back and trying to pull off the upset against the number 2 team ranked in the state. And here comes Douglasville as they are fighting back. They say they are ready to knock off the number 2 team in the state, and they give it to number 1, and number 1 is headed down the sideline for another 50-plus yard touchdown. As the Douglasville fans celebrate as they know their team has a chance to knock off the number 2 team in the state, Acworth says we are the number 2 team in the state for a reason, as they are fighting back like champions with this slim lead 13-12, and they give it to number 44 as he hits the sideline and he gives Acworth the lead 20-12. Douglasville has no quit in them as number 9 takes it around the left end, tries to find some yards, and gets down to the 20-yard line. Acworth has to rely on their defense, and they do, as number 75 makes the play of the game as he forces Douglasville to fumble and recovers the fumble as well, giving Acworth the win 20-12 in the pouring down rain.
Play tough defense, we're pulling the ball game out. We're looking forward to playing them again. We're looking forward to playing anyone.
Let's get started. Number 8, Henry County, Alabama versus Henry County, Georgia. And Henry County, Alabama starts it off early with number 21 going around the left side and getting into the end zone to give Alabama the lead 7-0. But Henry County, Georgia strikes back as they call their quarterback on a quarterback sweep. He breaks the tackle. You can see coach in the background jumping up and down on fourth down, and he gets into the end zone, tying up the game 7-7. Now in the fourth quarter with 3 minutes left, it's 13-13. Henry County linebacker blows up the center and gets into the backfield, making the tackle for the loss. I see you, coach. Tell him he did a good job. But Henry County, Alabama keeps coming back. They are the number 8 ranked team in the state for a reason. Coach calls a good play with the quarterback sneak. Quarterback runs down and makes it inside the 5-yard line. Now with a minute left in the game, the quarterback sneak is called again. And number 32 wins the game for them as they end up winning 20-13.
Well, these kids right here, they hadn't lost in 3 years, 4, 5, or 6, so they used to winning. We're winners. We're a bunch of winners. That's what I coach. I got a great parents, great kids, a great coaching staff. That's what makes us so good.
Right, the number 9 ranked Riverdale Blackhawks give it to number 21 to start the game off, and he comes down that left sideline, breaks the tackle, keeps on going, and makes it inside all the way down to almost to the 10-yard line. As you see, the Riverdale Blackhawks fans are excited. Then they go ahead and give it to number 21 again. Good block on the outside by the receiver. You didn't even see it, but it was a good block, and he gets into the end zone, giving the Blackhawks a lead 13-0. But Jonesboro said there is no quitting them. They're getting their chance to be on the big stage, and they give it to number 72. He breaks a couple of tackles, and he looks back, but he is headed down the middle of the field for 63 yards as he puts Jonesboro Gators back into the game 13-6. But the Riverdale Blackhawks are showing what they're the ninth ranked team in the state. They give it to number 21. He gets through the hole. He fakes out everybody, including his own man, to give Riverdale the win 20-6.
Every game, undefeated, going to the championship, and we ready for that Born to Compete Bowl, baby. We ready, baby. Yeah! Yeah!
BornToCompete.com!
Yeah! Put your heart deep, folks!
Get back out, move!
Put your heart deep, folks!
Get back!
As you can see, it's time to get it on. Ben Hill has that new turf that Coach Clark is very proud of. But Coach Matt Branch says, we are glad you put that new turf in, because number 32 is showing off his speed from welcome all as he gets down the sideline and gets welcome all on the board early. But then Ben Hill fights back. They give it to their running back. He is breaking tackles. He spins. And, Coach, we're not going to call this a fumble. We're just going to say he was running the option as number 8 gets the ball and gets into the end zone to tie the game up. But it was too much welcome all day long. As one of the top-ranked teams in the state, the welcome all Panthers at the 6-0 division, you see the running back here breaking a couple tackles, getting down the middle of the field, and welcome all wins the game 33-6 as they show why they are the top team in the Mayfield.
Guys, they've been working hard, you know, months, weeks, days, hours, on the minute, you know, and it showed up when the time was needed. You know, so all the glory goes to these hard-working young fellas, the coaches, and, you know, I thank my parents for the support also.
Bird, why me? 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 goddamn man.